What's up, guys? I think we left off in the northwestern region of the Yukon Territory up in Canada. Woke up that morning, took my time packing up, and then we rolled out. Drove for a couple hundred miles until we crossed the Canada-Alaska border. Well, guys, it's been a lot of driving, but we finally made it to Alaska. Man, it's far. It's really far. We haven't crossed the border yet. There's the customs office right up the road there. But yeah, it's just another milestone in our journey, and still a long way to go because Alaska's big, apparently. A lot of cool stickers. Check that out. Now, crossing the border from Canada back into the United States of America was a lot easier than entering Canada. It does help that I am a citizen of the United States. He pretty much looked at my passport, asked where I lived, asked why I was traveling to Alaska. Said just to road trip around Alaska, and he let me go. It took maybe 2 minutes max. So after crossing the border, I drove for another maybe 100 miles and then set up camp for the night. Nothing glamorous, just roadside parking and lots of mosquitoes. After that, woke up, continued driving further west towards Fairbanks. I think I fueled up in Tok. And then once I got to Fairbanks, I realized how early in the week it was. Pointed my compass south after looking on the map and seeing how close Denali National Park was. And that's where I'm sitting now. Just on the outskirts of Denali National Park is this small dirt road that leads up to a couple camp spots, and that is where I have called home for the past 2 nights. Very bumpy road, but the location is prime. And today, well, I'll tell you what I did today. I got to explore
Denali National Park in all its glory. Here's how that went. Stick around to find out, because I don't want to get mauled by an angry moose. Right where he was walking was where I was, so I'm glad I turned around. It doesn't look like a bull moose.
That's funny. Got back on the bus and just stopped for a little rest stop at the restrooms, and the bus driver said we'll be here about 15-20 minutes, but if you want to keep going then just start walking and I'll pick you up on the way. So we're walking. Back to the van. Let's see if she'll She's gonna be picky today. Hasn't been starting too great lately. Fired right up that time. Nice. So I decided to go on a hike today. Now that you're all caught up, but it's really windy again, so enjoy. After my hike yesterday, I didn't want to film anything because I was tired. It took the better part of the day. And after that, I went to get some pizza at a local shop in town and hung out there for a little bit. Then I came out to the same spot and camped out again. Now it's Sunday and I figured I'd better start heading back towards Fairbanks so I could catch a flight out tomorrow, but this will give me some time to do some laundry and take a shower and be civilized again. But my time here in Denali National Park has just been breathtaking, and just taking in all the views and experiencing how these people live out here. There's a lot of local workers out here that seem to have it pretty made, but yeah, I'm gonna go grab some coffee in town and start driving. It's Sunday morning, about 7 o'clock. It's very windy. It's another thing. I haven't been able to get outside and film much because, as you guys could tell, the past couple of days have been very windy. And you could hardly hear me over the mic. So, yeah. Today I'm driving to Fairbanks. And I think that's where I'm gonna end this video, and maybe I'll have another video come out before I'm at work for 2 weeks, but maybe not. Who knows? I don't know.